Hi everyone, we're going to verify trig identity using the difference of cubes, which is involving factoring and also common denominator stuff. So the first thing we're going to do, this one would be considered somewhat difficult if you don't know how to factor. But I'm going to go ahead and verify and work on the left side of the equation because it seems more complicated than the right side of the equation. And the first thing I'm going to do is just write everything in terms of sine and cosine. So we're going to have cosine of theta over sine of theta divided by 1 minus sine of theta over cosine of theta. So I'm just breaking everything up. And this one here would be sine of theta over cosine of theta divided by 1 minus cosine of theta over sine of theta. Now the next step I'm going to do is go ahead and write each of these pieces with the common denominator. So I'm going to go ahead and do that right in here, and then I'll rewrite it here. So this is my common denominator. So for this, you're going to get cosine theta minus sine theta over cosine of theta. And then you can go ahead and copy this down again. Cosine of theta over sine of theta. And do the same thing with this denominator. And let me erase this part right here. So you're going to get sine of theta minus cosine of theta over sine of theta. And then just copy this again. Sine of theta over cosine of theta. So if you're going through this one's kind of a long one. So if you want to go ahead and write this down, what we know is, if we look at this, this is a complex expression. I can write this, and I'm just going to do this one, as cosine of theta over sine of theta divided by cosine of theta minus sine of theta over cosine of theta. And then I'm going to change this to a multiplication and multiply it by cosine over theta times cosine of theta minus sine of theta. And what you're going to get is cosine squared of theta over sine times cosine theta minus, sine of theta. So that's how you kind of manipulate that. You're just kind of bringing this guy up here, and these two you multiply. And that's what I'm going to do on this one. So on the next one, so what we're going to have is cosine squared of theta over sine times cosine theta minus sine of theta plus sine squared theta over cosine theta times sine theta minus cosine of theta. So I just did the same thing on this side. Alright, now what we want to do is go ahead and do the common denominator here. My common denominator for these two is just going to be sine of theta cosine of theta times sine of theta minus cosine of theta. It's actually negative, because what I'm going to do here is, since these two are kind of flip-flopped, I can change one of these, which is this one, by multiplying the numerator and the denominator by negative. And when I multiply this by negative, it switches to sine times sine theta minus cosine of theta. Okay? And so that's the denominator right in here. Now, I'm going to go and put the negative in the numerator. So we have sine of theta, cosine of theta, times sine of theta, minus cosine of theta. Now, put the negative here, and to get the common denominator, you look at this, ask yourself what's missing, and what's missing is the cosine. So you're going to multiply that by your numerator. And then we have, plus, I'm going to look at this one. And looking at this, what's missing is your sine of theta, so we're going to multiply that by sine squared theta, sine of theta. All right? And the next thing you know is I can switch this. So this negative goes here. So I can write that as negative cosine. It doesn't go on the whole thing. It goes just right there. So it goes right there. And so if I put this as negative here, I'm going to write this part first because that's positive. So that's going to be sine cubed of theta minus, and then I'm going to write this part, cosine cubed of theta all over my least common denominator. Okay? Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my sum and difference of cubes, which is a cubed minus b cubed equals a minus b times a squared plus ab plus b squared. In this case, my a is sine of theta, and my b is cosine of theta. Okay, so I'm going to do that on the next slide. I'm going to get, for the first part, sine of theta minus cosine of theta times sine squared of theta plus sine theta cosine theta plus cosine squared of theta. That's the first part. And the next part is going to be and then I'm going to write this all over my common denominator, which is sine of theta, cosine of theta, times sine theta, minus cosine of theta. Now, what you notice is that this part here cancels out. So we have this quantity over this. And I'm going to split it up. Well, let me just write it out. Well, I'll go ahead and split it up. So we have sine squared of theta over sine theta cosine theta plus sine theta cosine theta over sine theta cosine theta plus cosine squared theta over sine of theta times cosine of theta. Now, simplifying here, this is 1. Sine goes into this sine squared 1 time. And this one, cosine, goes into cosine squared theta is cosine theta. So we have, I can put this first. We have 1 plus, this is sine over cosine, which is tan of theta. And this is cosine over sine of theta, which is cotan of theta, which is our desired result. Okay, that one was a difficult one. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye-bye.